The aviation industry, known for its dynamic challenges and high-stakes ventures, is continually evolving with technological advancements and market demands. One of the industry's most anticipated releases, Boeing's 777X, stands as a testament to this evolution. Heralded as a marvel of modern engineering, this aircraft aims to redefine long-haul travel. However, like many innovations, it has faced a series of hurdles since its inception. From regulatory challenges to global economic shifts, the journey of the 777X provides a glimpse into the complexities of launching a modern aircraft in today's ever-changing aviation landscape. Belonging to the 777X aircraft family, it is equipped with the largest and most potent turbofan engine globally. Equipped with a General Electric GE9X engine and novel composite wing, the 777X stands as Boeing's most expansive creation. This wing is so massive that it necessitates foldable wingtips to accommodate various airport gates. The 777X is available in two distinct variations, the Dash 8 and the Dash 9. Presently, these two aircraft are almost indistinguishable, differing solely in the fact that the Dash 8 features a slightly smaller fuselage and accommodates around 350 passengers. The intention behind the Dash 8 is to serve as a replacement for the older 777-300ER model. Interestingly, the 300ER has achieved remarkable success, positioning itself as the second best-selling widebody aircraft in history. Given this achievement, one would naturally anticipate strong sales for the Dash 8. Evidently, there exists a demand for an aircraft of this size. However, reality has not aligned with this expectation. Merely 40 units of the Dash 8 have been sold thus far, constituting a mere 10% of the existing 777X order backlog. This situation raises the question, why is the 777-8 failing? In the complex world of airplane design, development and deployment, timing is everything. And for certain aircraft, their grand entrance onto the aviation stage can be hamstrung by the very factor that's often hardest to predict, temporal relevance. Take for example, the challenges faced by the aircraft in question. Let's jet back to 2004 when the 300ER took off for the first time, boasting avant-garde avionics and a frugal fuel burn rate. These aerial marvels are still in their youth. Most of them haven't even hit their 20th birthday. Factor in the fleet's median age and it's clear, these planes still sport the just-out-of-the-factory sheen. The 300ER isn't just an aviation enthusiast's dream, it's an accountant's delight. Its blend of operational efficiency and seat mile costs make it a veritable golden goose for airlines. Why think about fleet revamps when you're riding a cash wave? However, fast forward a bit, and in about 10 to 15 years, boardrooms might buzz with fleet overhaul chatter. Now, back to the 777-8, a gleaming marvel of aviation but sadly shadowed in sales. But don't lament just yet. The 777-9, Dash 8's elder brother, is roaring with promise. This colossus, armed with a sprawling seating matrix, is all set to inherit the throne from the legendary 747-400, as the aviation world bids adieu to this classic jumbo, a vast aerospace beckons. The Dash 9 is raring to dominate this space. Need proof? Flip through the order books and backlogs. The 777X insignia is a frequent flyer there, signalling the ascendancy of a new aviation monarch. The skies are changing, and the era of the Dash 9 looms large. One might be tempted to prophesize that as a 300ER gracefully ages, taking its final bows, the Dash 8 will surge ahead, filling the skies as the sought-after replacement. But in the world of aviation, where the winds of change are as unpredictable as crosswinds on a stormy day, it's best to reserve judgment. The skies ahead, after all, are full of possibilities. While the Dash 8 wrestles with timing woes, a more intricate hurdle surfaces. Its potential oversized airframe design. Think about the new wings and engines we discussed. They're massive. But why? Designing an aircraft isn't a solo endeavor. Just like how Airbus pulls in customer feedback, the 777-8 creators did too. Qatar and Emirates are big players in the aviation industry. With a combined order of almost 200 units, their say mattered, much like a tech mogul influencing the specs of a new supercomputer. But here's the twist. These airlines reside in the Persian Gulf. Think blazing heat, wisp-like humidity, and airy atmospheres. In these conditions, a plane might struggle to achieve the necessary lift due to its wing design, which could lead to potential flight cancellations. So, these airlines, keen on avoiding desert downers, nudged Boeing for superior takeoff performance. Rumors brewed that they nudged a bit too hard, pushing for wings and engines larger than necessary. A solid idea for more lift, but the downside? Additional weight, potentially denting the aircraft's efficiency. like fitting a sports car with an oversized engine. Sounds powerful, but might just guzzle more fuel. Boeing faced a dilemma. While they were hesitant to modify their design, the saying "the customer is always right" echoed in their decisions. With the massive influence of Qatar and Emirates, Boeing found themselves in a corner. The result? The 777X, especially the Dash 8 variant, seems to have traded efficiency for performance. Here's the nitty-gritty. The Dash 8 shares the same engines and wings with the Dash 9. However, its body is more compact. The parts weren't optimized for the Dash 8, leaving it lugging extra weight. Comparatively, industry experts project the Dash 8's fuel efficiency to only improve by 13% over the 300ER. Need a clearer picture? The 737 MAX surpassed its predecessor, the 737 NG, by 14% in fuel efficiency by just swapping engines, no wing changes. Sure, a 13% boost might sound noteworthy, making the Dash 8 a worthy investment on paper, but in the real world, it's up against tough competitors. Stepping into the aviation ring, the Airbus A350-1000, with its cutting-edge, all-composite design, squares off against Boeing's Dash 8. Who holds the efficiency crown? That's still up in the air as both Airbus and Boeing root for their champs, casting a cloud of uncertainty over the debate. One undeniable fact though, the A350 is a lean contender, weighing in much lighter. If we bench press the numbers and assume the Dash 8 carries a tad more weight than the 300ER, due to its beefed up engines and wings, it tips the scales, being over 30,000 pounds chunkier than the A350. Now, it's not just about the weight, though that's a heavy factor when talking fuel consumption. But the twist in the tail? Boeing's weighty challenge wasn't set in stone. The heart of Boeing's angst? They could have sidestepped this. The roadmap to crafting a lighter aircraft, while keeping Qatar and Emirates' wishes front and centre, was available. Whispers in the early development phase hinted at Boeing eyeing a potential game-changer, aluminium-lithium, or Ally for the insiders. Ally isn't just another metal, it's about 10% lighter than its aluminium cousin, and toughens up against fatigue cracks, giving planes potentially longer flight mileage. Had Boeing gambled on Ally, the 777-8 and Dash 9 might have been the featherweights of their class, soaring with superior efficiency. Fresh off the Dreamliner debacle, marked by its audacious tech and costly delays, Boeing faced a crossroads. The allure of Ally beckoned, a new-age metal lighter and tougher than traditional aluminium. Yet, Boeing's wariness prevailed. Why? Think of a chef who once got burned trying a new recipe. Would he risk another culinary experiment? Scarred by the 787's turbulence, Boeing worried Ally might reroute the 777X down a similar costly detour, inflating both component and production bills. So, they chose the safer, time-honored aluminium runway for the 777X. Now, fast forward. Ally's star has risen. It's the golden child of the aviation world, flaunting its prowess in aircraft like the A220. Some even whisper it could dethrone composites as the aircraft material of the future. Boeing's missed flights with Ally not only meant bypassing a pioneering moment, but also left the Dash 8 grappling with its weighty dilemmas. So, does the 777-8 stand any chance? Every cloud has its silver lining, and for the 777-8, it's not just about overcoming challenges, but also about unleashing potential. If range were a sport, the 777-8 would be the marathon runner of the skies. Covering a whopping 8,800 nautical miles, it's not just the best in Boeing's lineup, but a leap beyond its predecessor. And there's a growing market for such stamina. Take Qantas's London to Perth stretch. Not only are these ultra-long-haul flights a reality, but they're also minting profits. If the aviation world continues its romance with long distance, the 777-8 isn't just ready, it's primed for dominance. The 777-8 could also be freighters' new favourite workhorse. Since Boeing unveiled its freighter version, sales charts show it eclipsing its passenger sibling. Why? Think of airlines still clutching on to the aging MD-11s or 747-200s. It's like swapping an old sedan for a fuel-efficient hybrid. And don't be shocked if Boeing pulls an unexpected change, launching the Dash 8 freighter ahead of the passenger model. Yes, the Dash 8's path has been a roller coaster, but with endurance and adaptability as its co-pilots, it's glimpsing a horizon filled with promise. In conclusion, the Boeing 777X's journey embodies the intricate dance between innovation and market realities. While its predecessor, the 300ER, was a testament to technological finesse, the Dash 8's trajectory highlights the challenges of meeting evolving market demands while balancing past successes. At the heart of the 777-8's trials lie the dynamics of customer influence, engineering challenges, and an aversion to risks rooted in previous experiences. As the tale of the Dash 8 unfolds, it serves as a potent reminder that in the aviation industry, balancing innovation with market demands is akin to flying in turbulent skies. The key is to keep adapting to the winds of change. While it has been a rocky ascent for the Dash 8, the skies ahead still gleam with opportunity. For Boeing and the 777-8, the journey might have been filled with turbulence, but as with any epic saga, it's not about the challenges encountered, but the altitude achieved.